lot, over the years, a lot of hard decisions had to be made around tables like this, and I had at times the opportunity to be part of them. The decisions at the time made were so Calumet would not only survive, but thrive. About 18 years ago, we all heard about privatization without a plan. The rate of decline in support of the legislature would continue. State-owned universities would be completely private in 10 to 15 to 12 years. It was always prefaced with the realization that the government could bankrupt Pasadena schools in any given year if we reached that point. At Calumet, we've been planning for this. Over the years, former President Armenti moved Calumet to operate like a private university. In 1993, Dr. Armenti unveiled a $250 million master plan to improve academic buildings, residence halls. We invested in technology, infrastructure, accrediting academic programs. We developed many new programs, academic programs. We started an activity transcript, became the leader in Google Online. Cal started its first capital campaign and established many student scholarships. Enrollments nearly doubled while raising academic standards, which is not the case at many universities. Calumet survived the Civil War, World War I, World War II, other conflicts the U.S. did in, depression, other downturns in funding and the economy. I believe Calumet continues, as it continues its 160-year existence, it will survive this, and will survive lack of support from the Commonwealth and again thrive in the future.
We are, however, disheartened that the first item on the agenda for the first Council of Trustees meetings is the dismissal of Dr. Armenti, and not a future-oriented discussion of how California University can pick itself up in the face of this adversity and prepare an academics-first approach. We are disheartened that the main concern is over this one person rather than the future of our beloved university and the students who study here. It is your responsibility and charge as trustees to ensure that this university will be here for years to come. It is your responsibility to listen to all who voice opinions and to investigate any claims of misconduct. It is your responsibility to live up to your own responsibilities, something you have not been doing. As a result, we have a convocation center that is much too large for the size of this campus, a center that took precedence over some of our aging classrooms and buildings that are still in need of replacement and renovation. We challenge you to walk through those neglected academic buildings. You will see windows so old that they are nearly falling out of the building. Stink bug infestations. Antiquated cooling and heating systems. Worn out or malfunctioning equipment and outdated computer labs. The list could go on. We implore you as the Council of Trustees of California University of Pennsylvania to, number one, put California on the academics first track by emphasizing and focusing finances solely on education. Two, mandate transparency in all decisions affecting this institution, particularly in the area of finances. And three, to mandate true shared